But it was. Thank you very much, Big Sis. And the main reason that I stand before you today is because of my grandmother, Mary Ford. A couple weeks ago, she went to the hospital to have a blood clot unblocked on her leg. And while she was under, she had a heart attack. But she pulled through. She's doing much better now. And people often ask me, say, Shannon, why are you so determined? Why are you so dedicated? Because I remember my grandmother telling me and my brother something when we were little boys. And my grandmother didn't want a whole lot when we became successful. But I just remember my grandmother saying, before my lifetime ends on this earth, I want to live in a decent house. Decent house. And I asked, I said, Grand, what is a decent house? She said, son, one night I want to go to bed. And while I'm sleeping, it's raining, I don't want to get wet. I remember as a small child, in the middle of the night, putting raincoats on the bed so my brother, my grandmother, and I, we wouldn't get wet. I remember putting pots and pans in the middle of the floor so the floor wouldn't get soaked. I remember that. That drove me. And every coach would tell you, that coach me and said, why are you so determined? Why are you so driven? I said, because I don't want to eat cold oatmeal, and I don't want my grandmother to ever be wet again. Granny, I stand before you. I know you're not here, and I wish you were, to see the man that you raised in me and my brother. It means the world to me that you are my grandmother. I got a couple special friends, Daryl Buck and McCormick, who's been one of my best friends for 20 years. James Jimbo Gillen, who while I was away in Baltimore and Denver would go by my house.